I dropped by one of Ed Mirvish's farewell events with my friends Roland and Travis. Put on by the Center for Social Innovation and Toronto for Everyone, the event was called Amazement, and it was totally amazing. Almost 10,000 square feet of art installations, performances, film, and music all happening concurrently. So it was as crazy as it was exhilarating. Aside from all the amazing memorabilia, the place was lit up with projections, lighting sculptures. It was pretty amazing, but you could still feel the sad. I mean, after all, this is the death of a cultural icon. And this place, or this event, in many ways, is kind of like a celebration of life service after someone passes, except it's also a rockin' party. Caught up with queer artist Adrienne Crossman, who had a fuzzy stolen from her installation like literally just moments ago. What's a fuzzy, you ask?
My work is called Queer Still Life Part 1, and it is a video and installation in the old lunchroom at Honest Ed's. So basically the work stemmed from the Pioneer plaque that NASA sent out in the late 70s, so 1979, that was critiqued basically out of an illustration that was supposed to demonstrate to extraterrestrial life what humanity was. So I wanted to queer the image and make it more inclusive. My brain went to the Furby as this non-binary queer icon, because to me they inhabit this in-between space of both, like, you know, fake real because they're animated. They inhabit like a non-binary gender space, and they don't really adhere to most of the categories that we would, in the way that we would categorize people. And then the body of work that I made stems from that idea.
I caught up with one of the organizers who said that because of the success of this year's show, there's talk of doing another version. I certainly hope so.